I really strongly believe in something so very simple that when one's life gets tied with difficulties, maybe depression and things like that, stress, that is negative energy working on you, and that it is so very simple as to force yourself to go out. For me, I'm lucky, I'm surrounded by woods and fields, so I can go out there and I know, I just look and think, this is full of positive energy. There is nothing negative about this. And pick up that wonderful feeling, uplifting feeling of positive energy from the woods, from the trees and the fields and every living thing, and to pull it into you, and you go up. It's very hard to feel depressed. Pencil is absolutely wonderful, and a pencil and a rubber is even better, because you have that wonderful confidence that if what you do, I don't like that bit, that you can wipe it out and start again. But it's a very sensual thing, actually, having a piece of wood in your hand with a lead in the middle and just drawing onto paper. It is absolutely wonderful. I can lose myself in it for hours and hours. Oh, yeah, I always know what I'm going to draw. What I end up with is not necessarily what I originally intended to draw. Very often find that it's almost as though something else is pushing you in a certain direction, and you stand back and you look at what you've drawn and you see something else coming out of it that was not intended in any way, and you sometimes it's a crease in the paper, sometimes it might be just a watermark that you've left when you put your tea down or something, and so often that is something that can take over, and it's like drawing something out of the air onto your paper. If you stare at trees, it's very hard. Well, I find it really hard to not see faces in trees. And if I'm stuck, and if I sit somewhere with trees around me and I look at the markings on the bark, it is full of faces. It's impossible to be bored in front of a tree. There are so many things hidden there, and sometimes it's just lovely to lift that out of the tree. And on that particular one, I've got him coming out of the side of the tree. It's like a spirit of place, something from the woods. The woods are full of spirits. The woods are full of all sorts of entities that we have a multitude of names for them. I mean, we've got classical names, you know, dryads from the Greeks who lived in the trees. We've got piskies down here in Cornwall. We've got great tradition of fairies down here in Cornwall, and there are loads of labels that you can put on things, but I don't know what to call them. There are definitely places in the woods where the woods do not want you to be, and you will get pushed away, and you think you're going to walk through a place, and you find yourself walking around the outside And you think, well, why did I do that? I didn't want to go there. I think it's a drifting off. I think there's a period of possibly coming to terms that you are dead, because your soul has migrated. You're weightless. You're bodiless, and I think when death happens suddenly in tragic circumstances, it takes people a long time to realise that they're actually dead. I think you're suddenly aware of your surroundings, but you're completely unaware of what has actually happened to you. You're weightless, you're bodiless. You're able to drift about, you're able to see your own body. I think that's it's probably the first intimation you have of actually being dead. It's like one of those dreams when you leave your body and you're conscious of leaving your body. When we are reborn, which I do believe strongly in, whether we are exactly the same soul that we left, or whether we possibly amalgamate and become a mixture of other people's memories and experiences. But I am quite sure that we do move on, and we do come back to birth again. And I don't know, there are so many theories, aren't there, from different religions, that we learn from our past mistakes and have to reincarnate into a form that we can learn again and learn different things, learn from our mistakes. I really don't know, but when you see the world around you, when you see a plant that in its own way reincarnates every year, you know, it appears to die down to absolutely nothing. It's embodied into a seed. That seed hits the ground and comes back up again. I don't think there's anything that more complicated than that. We are indestructible. We are indestructible if we want to be indestructible. Divine is the perfect balance between male and female. The source, the intelligence behind absolutely everything. I'm a great believer in science as well, but I can quite happily incorporate science with my beliefs, and to me nothing conflicts at all.
Like?
Oh, he's very benevolent. Yeah. Yeah, no, it's a very benevolent face, that one. Very.
You think that's why I like him?
Yes, I think that's probably why, yeah. Yeah, it's a very warm face.
So, is that your mission?
Yes, yeah, I guess so. I so much want to be a catalyst for other people seeing things. I think that it was a great gift that was given to me. I don't eat the paintings, don't I? I think it was a great gift that was given to me, which I feel very strongly that I need to pass on. And if I can show people things that I see, then I hope that I will be able to inspire other people to look. I mean, that is part of my mission in life, either through my paintings or to find people to pass on knowledge to. And I'm always looking for people who would like to see more. It's seeing is such an important part of to be able to see through the veil and to see through to something else that exists behind the normal world.